Well, I'm finally getting around to making some adjustments and some corrections to my solar oven. When I made this, I'd never done anything solar before, and this was my first solar oven project. And I've since come to realize that it's just too big an area. This is really big, and I do tend to overdo things sometimes. So what I'm going to do, I've got 4 inches from the back wall to this front edge. I'm going to fill all that in with cardboard all the way down here. And right here, there's 6 inches from the top edge of this to the bottom edge. So I'm going to fill all that in with cardboard. So I'm going to have cardboard in the back bringing it out and cardboard on the floor bringing it up. And that will decrease the amount of area that needs to be heated. And then my reflectors, I realized with some experimentation with a mirror that the angle I had my reflectors set at was completely wrong. 70 degrees from my experiments is the optimal angle to the glazing, the glass. So, I've got my wood cut out. I didn't figure that would be interesting enough to show. You've all seen wood cut. What I'm going to do now is take this into my living room, all 4 of these pieces, and I'm going to trace these out on the reflective material that I have. About a 4x8 sheet from a place called American Acrylics. And basically, it's about a 1/16 of an inch thick, maybe a little more. And it's like a mirror. So I'm going to be cutting them out and gluing them on and then assembling this with some aluminum angle that I bought. And then I'm going to mount it to that with a hinge so I can open the door. Anyway, I'm going to get to work. Okay, I've got all these angled pieces traced out on my 4x8 sheet of reflective polycarbonate. I'm going to cut them out with some shears and take them to my shop and rubber cement them all together. And I'll show you that when I'm done. Alright, I got all my pieces cut. And I got my glue. Then I'm going to start spraying this down. I'm going to have to read on the back of that to see how long it's going to take to dry. I may have to set some paint cans on that to hold it down. And I got this aluminum angle here that I'm going to hold the whole thing together with, the corners. Alright, I'm going to start gluing it down. Alright, there's one. It took me long enough. I'm holding the corners together, I think I mentioned it already, with this aluminum angle. It's 1x1 and got all my holes drilled. I got 2 of them mounted. And I didn't go overboard with screws this time. I really showed restraint. I'm proud of myself. Alright, 3 more. Have it all screwed together. I'll have this part of it done today. See you in a bit. Alright, I got 2 sides connected. I want a little peek at how shiny this stuff is. Hello. I'm going to leave that on until I'm finished. 2 more. Almost done. Well, I got it resting on there. I haven't quite figured out how I'm going to, it's got to be able to hinge. I think I've got an idea. I think I'm going to come up with a board straight like this between both these hinges. and then come up with a board on this side and a board on this side and butt it into that piece on both sides. And I'll be able to just tilt this backwards, fold it back, and then open the door up. I tell you what, I make this thing any heavier, I'm going to put a fifth wheel hitch and a heavier suspension and shocks. And I went a little bit overboard on building this, but I got so much time and so much money into this, I'm just determined to make it work. So this is it. This is called the Heaven's Flame Reflector, and I've got it at 70 degree angle to the glazing. And the way I came to that measurement was just experimenting with a mirror at different angles. And at 70 degrees, with the glazing exactly square to the sun, at 70 degrees, the mirror was reflecting the sun to the dead center of the solar oven. So I just can't think of anything better than dead center. So there we go. I've got a few more things to do. I still got to put the cardboard on the inside and mount this hinging thing here. I'm not 100% set on how I want to do it. I may think about it overnight. But maybe I'll put this up and show you my progress. See ya.
There you go. After disassembling the NASA helmet, the first process is to sand it down and then get it ready for bodywork. This thing's got a lot of old paint on it.
You guys are tired.
It's got some material on it. I don't even know what it is. It's going to take a lot of work to get the thing smooth in order for us to be able to get ready to paint. We've been working on a gas cart for a few days now. The goal of this restoration is to make it fully functional, and that means
crazy
Daisy. Gas.
Are you tired?
What we're going to do is we're going to 415 inside there. The 415, what that's going to do for us is make it to where when they do put fuel in it, it doesn't end up contaminating the fuel, the rust.